Welcome to Punarvasi Technologies. www.punarvasi.com is my website. I wrote more than 500 articles on SAP Basis NetWeaver administration in this website. Many people got benefited from my articles, and I have trained students throughout the world. So in this video, I wanted to show you how to install, how to apply patches to an SAP system using SPAMTcode, SPAM. Here is the SAP system. Before running SPAMTcode, just let me show you the status of the system. Means I'll show you the release and the patch level of each component. In this system, there are four components are available, that is software components are four, and out of these four components, this one is ABAP component, and this is basis plugin, and this is BW component. Here if you look at release number 700 and the level is 0014, that is patch level is 0014 of ABAP component, and basis component just I have applied one more patch here, that is 0015. Before recording this video, I have applied the patch to the basis component, and I'm going to show you how to apply the patch to the ABAP component. In the same way, you can apply the patches to all the components, just you need to have the patch files, okay? And let me show you that. So after completion of this experiment, this SAP underscore ABA should have 0015 level, okay? So let us go to the SPAMTcode. SPAM is the T code for applying patches. From here you can look at present package level, that is status. If you click on this package level, it will show all the levels, that is whatever we have seen just now, same thing, same information will be displayed here. SAP basis, basis component, and it will show like this. And if it is a ABAP component, double click on it, it will show like this. That is support package level is 0014, okay? And now my intention is to install, means apply the ABAP patch, okay? So for that purpose, I am just directly going to the server, and I have connected to my server using remote desktop connection, just opening it. And you should have the file, related file, that is patch file. So here you see SAP NetWeaver 7.0 ABAP stack up to 27 patch levels are there. Just double click on the SAP underscore ABA underscore 700, and 14 the patches are applied. That 15 one I have to apply now. Just copy that particular file and paste it in the trans directory of your SAP server, that is C:USR SAP trans. Here you just click on the paste, and the inside EPS in directory right now nothing is there. Just you have to extract this particular patch to that using SAP car file. So that right click here and click on the copy address, go to command prompt and the cd space, right click, paste, so that it will go to that particular directory. Hit enter, C:USR SAP trans, I am there. Just directory type dir so that it will display all the files that are available in that particular directory. From here you just type SAP and tab, so that the SAP car underscore 315-2010453.exe file will be displayed like this. This is the command that you have to run, space hyphen xvf, and the file you need to extract is ka70015.sar. that is only the file you copied just now. This is the file ka70015.sar, okay? So ka, you type ka and tab, hit tab so that the entire file will be displayed like this. Okay, so once you type entire command, just hit enter from your keyboard to extract the file. Okay, hit enter. So like that, these two files will be extracted into the directory called EPS in directory. This EPS in directory is electronic parcel service. Inside that inbox, so inside the files will be generated within this trans directory. Just double click on EPS and double click on in so that the files will be displayed like this. And now you are ready to upload these files to the SAP system. Just I have minimized the SAP server, and from the front end GUI I have connected to the server using SAP GUI for Windows. And from here click on the support package, load packages from application server. Within the spam decode you have to run this particular step. Okay, and it will look into that particular directory, that is NW7HP1 SAP MNT trans EPS IN. So over network it is connecting, that's why it is taking the UNC path, that is network path. NW7HP1 is the server host name of my server, that is from here you can find out the host name of the server, that is NW7HP1. And over that this SAP MNT is the share name of SQL and USR, and after SQL and USR trans directory, after SQL and USR, SQL and USR SAP, SQL and USR SAP is named as SAP MNT. Okay, if you look at this share name, you see the right click and click on the properties and the sharing. Here you see this is the local path. If you click on the advanced sharing, you can find out this SAP MNT also. So two share names are there for this particular directory. Okay, so that over network you can call this, it will check like this. Okay, and click on the yes button to upload the file, upload successfully, that is 0029668. 0029668. Just look into the directory trans EPS IN 0029668. Okay, and now click on the go back button from here and click on the display or define button. Display or the define button. Once you upload the file, just click on the display or define button. Now you are interested to apply the patch of ASAP underscore ABAS, so that double click on that, just a single click, so that it will display the file that is available for applying. Okay, just click that and click on the confirm queue so that that number will come like this. Do you want to add modification adjustment transport to the queue? Click on the S and click on the accept selected adjustment request, and the number will be displayed like this, and the spam status turns to from green traffic signal to yellow triangle signal, queue initialized. Okay, and once you get this queue here, just click on the support package, click on the confirm button, click on the confirm button, sorry, click on the import queue, click on the import queue, so that queue will be started like this. You can either start this particular job in the dialog or background job. Like if you want to start this particular job in the background, you have to click on the start options. From here you have to select the start in background immediately and click on the continue button. Okay, so it is little bit lengthy job, so that it is always better to start in the background immediately only. Just click on the continue button and continue in background and click on the import button. And import job scheduled and spam status turns to red traffic signal. And job OCS underscore Q underscore import scheduled. So you can look at this particular information from the background administration, means background monitoring, that is SM37 is the T code for looking at the different types of jobs that are running already in the system. And from here you can select all the options, or you can also just select released, active, finished, cancel. So right now whatever the jobs are active, it will show. Click on the execute button so that OCS underscore import Q underscore import job should be displayed like this. Click on the refresh button. So still it is running, and click on the refresh until it completes. You have to wait. And meanwhile you can also look at the SM50 T code, that is it will show the background work process view for you, that is the background work process that is right now is utilizing for running that particular job, that is BZD, that is work process number 12. Okay, so you can look at that particular job OCS underscore Q underscore import and click on that job log, so that particular job log will be displayed like this. And also you can double click on that particular job to get more details about that particular job. Click on the job details and it will display like this, that is work process number 12 is performing this particular job. So whatever the number you are able to looking at here, so this particular background work process is running for this particular job. Okay, so finally, once that particular background job is finished, you will you can come to this particular screen and click on the refresh button, so that once it is done you can click on the support package and click on the confirm button. Okay, I'll pause the video here, just I'll come back with the successful screen here. Okay, OCS underscore Q underscore import job is completed. Okay, within 519 seconds it is completed. Just click on the refresh, that is the start time is 554.30 seconds and 519 seconds it has taken to finish the job. So let us go back to the support package manager. Just click on the refresh button here so that the red traffic symbol will be converted to yellow triangle color. Okay, so once you get this color, just click on the support package and click on the confirm button and it turns to green. Now just check it up the status of your patch, that is ABAP patch. Just go to ABAP, SAP underscore ABAP, SAP KA70015. So in this way you have to apply the patches one by one, or if you have the latest patch directly you can apply the latest patch. Okay, I hope you understood. If you have any questions or doubts, you can leave your comments in my website, or you can send me an email directly. And right now I have not posted any videos in YouTube channel, just because of some problems by SAP, so that I have removed all the videos from the YouTube channel. So if you need all of my videos, that is more than 100 videos are available, you can directly download my videos by paying my fee. Thanks for watching.